Hey guys, and welcome back to this channel. This is Anna's kitchen, and today we are making a burger from scratch. Yes, we are making a burger from scratch. So first things first, I added some sugar, some salt. I had some yeast, then some all-purpose flour and some hot water or some hot milk. I mixed that. First things first is this burger bun. I was making the burger bun first. That's me there kneading the dough. And by the way, in today's video, you are going to see the raw and unfiltered, unedited video of how I make my recipes. The only thing I've done to this video is I have fast forwarded it. That's the only thing I've done this video. The rest is raw, unfiltered, and edited. So after kneading the dough for a while, I added some oil. And then I covered it and I left it to rise for an hour. Then I wiped my surface and I returned all the things where they're supposed to be returned. Yes. These are the behind, how is it called? Behind the scenes, yes, behind the scenes of what you don't see on toothpaste. Next is me making the burger patties. Some beef, minced beef. Then some garlic and ginger, much made in heaven. Then allspice, mixed spice. Beef masala, some salt, some paprika, and some cayenne pepper, and some soy sauce. And then I returned everything where it's supposed to be. I cleaned my hands, then some a teaspoon of vegetable oil. I mixed everything up to make sure all the spices are well incorporated. Then it was time to make the burger patties into those small rounds. By the way, if you are new to this channel, please consider subscribing. We love visitors on this channel. Subscribe, give this video a thumbs up, comment, and share it with your friends. Most importantly, subscribe and give this video a thumbs up. You'll see a lot of washing the hands in this video. So I kept the burger patties in the fridge for about 45 minutes. Then I went ahead to cut these onions to make the sauteed onions. In a hot pan, I added some vegetable oil and some butter, unsalted butter. And then I added the onions. And I left them to cook for about 20 minutes. By this time the dough had risen, so I lined my baking tray with a parchment paper. My dough had risen. I punched it to remove the air, the excess air. And now it was time to make the balls. Always clean as you go. So those were my burger buns. And then I beat one egg and I put it on top of the buns so that we can come out with that brown color on the top. And then I put them in a preheated oven to cook for 25 minutes at 180 degrees Celsius. my onions are ready. I decided to clean the pan, and then I added some little oil. I removed my burger patties from the fridge for them to cook, and this pan almost messed me up. I cooked each side for about 4 minutes on each side. And then when I flipped over, I added some cheese on top of every bun, on top of every patty. You see the way the pan almost messed my burger patties. So I had to change this pan. I changed the pan to a better one. This one was not sticking. I repeated the same process of adding the cheese. Personally, I'm not a fan of cheese. I'm not a fan of mayonnaise. So most of these burgers were eaten by my food testers, of which you'll see one of them in this video. Then 25 minutes were over, the burger buns were ready. I had to brown them in this pan with some unsalted butter. Making these burgers was a lot of work because it took me around 3 hours. But as we say, kitchen hyphen December. But I'll do that. I will do this again and again for my customers, for my friends, but not for myself. For myself, I better go buy. So the sauce I mixed. Some natural yogurt with some ketchup and some salt and some coriander or dania, because no one in this house eats mayonnaise. Not me, not my friend who you'll see here. Okay. So I opted for the natural yogurt and some ketchup. And there's also sweet. So I applied the sauce on the bottom of the burger bun, added some lettuce, the burger patty, some onions, the sauteed onions, and the tomatoes. And then it was time to taste. This was me testing and it was very, very sweet. Although I'm not a fan of cheese, but I ate it because it was sweet. And this is the behind the scenes of someone here coming to taste this food before it was served. This is what you don't see when I edit the videos. Now I decided to assemble for the presentation. I had roasted some potatoes because we also don't eat fried potatoes. I repeated the process. I added the potatoes, the roasted potatoes, the sauce and the onions, and it slapped. Now this is the official taster of this food. And that's it for this week's video. Thank you very much for watching. Please consider subscribing to this channel if you have not subscribed. Give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friend, and comment down on the comment section on how I did it. If you do this recipe, if you have any questions you want to ask, comment down below, and see you on the next one.